Hi, Cathy O'Reilly here with some education today on how to build your business, how to keep your clients happy, how to make more money, how to feel more secure. And I'd like to say, the first thing I'd like to say to you is that I think it's important to really go back, right back to the very beginning of why, you know, people come to you in the first place, and remember the beautiful soft skills we bring to our jobs every day. I mean, we're in the very, very enviable position that we've got contact with people, we can communicate with people still, we can give them ourselves, and really that's why they come. It's about the feeling we give them, the sense of warmth and friendliness and being heard and being seen. And as a hairdresser, all done through the years, that was the part that I really enjoyed the most. And it comes through in your education with your staff, your team, and above all with your clients. So I think that this lecture today is really more about our soft skills, which are really our gift. Our gift as hairdressers is that we've got lots of soft skills and we bring them to the table. And as of today, in today's world with COVID, it's so important to make people feel welcome. We can still do that with a mask on. We've got a beautiful pair of eyes we can smile with. You can make people feel welcome. You can still talk to people. You can still make them feel at home when they walk in that door. So the first thing I'd like to look at today is, why does your first time client walk in the door to you and leave the original salon that she's always gone to? Some place that she went the first day and stayed maybe for quite a while, and she's now decided she'd like a change. So I'd like to look at a number of reasons. And I remember being at a lecture years ago and they asked us this question, why do you lose clients? And we all came up with the obvious answers, like she'd like a change and wasn't being offered it. She was getting the same haircut every time she went into her stylist. The relationship had become too personal. There wasn't enough about her hair anymore. She didn't feel heard anymore, seen by the hairdresser that she was going to. She felt taken for granted. And actually, we were wrong. We were so shocked. The room was full of very experienced salon owners, salon stylists that had years of experience. And actually, the real reason that you lose a client, regardless of whether it's hairdressing salon or any other type of service industry, is they feel that the person that's dealing with them has become indifferent. And I was so shocked. Indifferent. I thought, God, that really cuts through the chase for me, because I can see how it can happen, but it's an awareness around it that'll stop us from doing it going forward. It's so important to be aware of this awful thing that we do to people. Because we see them every week, we might see them every month, we might see them 6 times a year, we become kind of indifferent. No, we don't want that. No. I'd like to talk to you now about your branding. You know, I just love Instagram. I love Facebook. I think it's fantastic. It's really wonderful way to get out there. And it's such a wonderful forum. You know, it's great because years ago, many, many years ago, we spent a fortune on advertising. And you can just get on there and you can do it now. It's great. And it's great. It's creative. And it gets people together as a team. And it makes them work on their Instagram. And it makes them work hard at getting stuff out there. And I think it's fantastic. And really, at the end of the day, it's something that is so popular now and so used. So when people are making the decision to go to a salon, they're going to go to your Instagram page and your Facebook page. So that's going to be very relevant to what they're expecting from you when they come to the salon. So what I'm asking you today, these are questions I'm going to ask you. Maybe you should take out a notepad now and start writing a few things down to ask yourself the question and be totally honest. I'm not going to be with you. You'll be on your own in the room answering these questions. And as an owner, as a senior stylist, I want you to sit down and ask yourself this question. Is what you're putting up on Facebook and Instagram, is that the experience they get in your salon? If it does, 10 out of 10. I think it's fantastic. It's really important that when you're using that as your brand, that that's what they will get as the experience, because that's why they're drawn to you. Okay? That's important. The next thing that we're going to look at is, maybe it's a friend, you know, of theirs that recommended you. What do you think that friend said about you? Why do you think she recommended you? Who was she that recommended you? Think about that client and ask yourself, what's so special about me that she recommended me? What kind of experience is that client going to expect from me because her friend recommended me? So think about that. That's another one to ask yourself. And ask yourself, and also I would say to you is that, how would this friend describe you to your friend as a stylist? What would she say about you? So now we're into, what is your client going to expect when she comes in? What are her expectations? What does she think she's going to get between your Facebook, Instagram, friends recommending you? You sound amazing. What is she going to expect? And when she gets there, what's she going to see? So let's look at your salon from the outside. I'm walking past the door. I'm looking in and thinking, this is the salon. She's in there. I booked an appointment with her. What do I see? This is very important. This is also part of your branding. So let's look at it from your point of view. Be the owner for a minute. Be the owner outside the door looking at your own shop. Is it clean? Are the windows clean? Does it look bright on the inside? Is the lighting good enough? Are your products merchandised properly on the shelves on the window? Do you have enough stock on the window? That's very important before she even gets in. This is what she sees. And sometimes as an owner, we're so busy getting in there in the morning to open the door to look after the clients, we forget to look from the outside in. I think it's a great idea to get out your camera and actually film the outside of your shop. Go home, look at it, tweak it and say, stock looks bad, windows aren't clean. If they're clean and the stock is great, again, 10 out of 10, good for you. But there's always room for improvement. And this, again, is your brand. Before they even get into the salon, this is what they're going to see. It's very important that you're going to be aware of every single detail. And is in the thing about a business, and I ran a business for 35 years, and I'm still involved in the supplies business, the devil is in the detail. It's the small things that matter. So the big things we expect will be okay, but it's the small things that clients are going to see. You know, as a stylist, you're always thinking about my cutting skills. You're always thinking about your colouring skills. You're always thinking about product selection. But as a customer, you're seeing the other stuff. So you've got to see through her eyes. Did you know this is a fact? Another shocking fact that I discovered again at a lecture one time. I was so taken back by this. And I suppose over the years, I went to so many, many educational lectures. There's certain things really stood out for me. It takes 4 seconds for someone to assess you. I was like, 4 seconds? I mean, you wouldn't even blink a few times in 4 seconds. It takes 4 seconds for somebody to walk into your business and to make a very quick synopsis of you. And you the same. I mean, think about it. If you meet a stranger for the first time, you'll make your judgment very quickly. So this is also very important to remember as a stylist. I think as a junior starting off, from an assistant, an apprentice, an owner, it's very, very important to remember that it takes 4 seconds for that stranger to assess you. So the first thing I would say to you is, how do you look in the morning when you wake up? I remember saying to my girls when they used to come into work, I say, what do you want me to wear for the salon when they start me? I say, look, I just want you to look in the morning like you're going out and not coming home. And I mean, that was the funniest thing really, because they used to laugh at me. But to me, it's important to get up in the morning and look like you're going to some place special during the day. It's your place of work. You should look wonderful. You should celebrate your day, particularly now, to have a job, to celebrate your day, to meet your clients. So I think that's number one. How do you look? How do you smell? How do you feel? I mean, how you actually feel inside is the way you're going to dress, the way your hair is going to look, your makeup is on for the day. That's the first thing. Next thing then is, you know, how are you going to communicate to people? Now, sometimes communication is something that's overlooked, but again, it's one of our soft skills and we are really, really good at it. When I first started hairdressing, I'm going to share something with you that is the God's gospel truth. I couldn't say a word from one end of the week to the other. I was the quietest child inside in that salon. I mean, I really was. I couldn't talk. I wasn't able. But you know what? I learned a few things to say to break the ice. I just learned that that was the way to be. And sometimes you learn a lot as a young person from watching more experienced people. And I think in the salon, this is where I'm going to speak to the owners and the senior people. You've got to mentor your young staff. You know, I mean, communication is something that you develop over the years and you become more comfortable with who you are. I know I'm an example of it, but honestly, it took me so long. And at the end of the day, you can take people through a lot more quickly by just being around them and showing them how it's done in a very simple way. And I've got this thing that I think is just brilliant. It's SEC, S-E-C. Now you have to see it. It's just so easy. And all it is smile, eye contact, and comment. SEC. And it takes a second. That's why we call it SEC. And smile, eye contact, and comment. It could be a comment like, it's a nice day today. Welcome to the salon. It doesn't have to be a huge conversation. And another thing I learned about communication was people love to talk about themselves. They love to be heard. So you can always start, if you're a bit shy in a salon, by just asking, how are you, and talking about them. And believe me, that will give you a fair amount of scope, because people do like to hear their own voice. And that's also a great start. So SEC, S-E-C, smile, eye contact, and last but not least, comment. Let's talk about your phone skills. This is a very important part of your business. This is the part where people will get to you first. This is their first point of contact. So what I would say to you today is, what does she have to do to get to you? Is her transition made easy? Does the phone ring out? Does it go like 10 times before somebody answers? If you're in the position to have, you know, a lucky position, I was always lucky enough in my salon to be able to afford a receptionist. But in today's world, it may not be possible. But there are phone skills, and there is a tone of voice, and there is a way of fitting people in. It's very important that the skills that are put in place for reception are learned by whoever is going to answer that phone. So I think that this is a very important area. Again, it can be overlooked. I know myself from ringing salons myself, it's just something I've happened to notice, that like, it shouldn't ring any more than two times, because people are frustrated enough out there at the moment. And to have to wait for somebody to answer the phone is a real, it's, for me personally, it gets on my nerves. I don't like it. And I think that when people are waiting too long, it puts them in bad form before they get talking to the receptionist. So I think that there should be a limit on how many times that phone should ring. Again, there's training around that. We do all the training on any area I've spoken about so far. We will do one-to-one training with you in your salon for you and design it around your needs. But I think that your phone skills, it's very important that when people are getting that first point of contact with you, that it should be done with ease. It shouldn't be a problem. There should be words used to make it sound like it's going to be solved. Even if there isn't a space in the book, we'll give them what we can. We look after them in any way we can get them in. I know salons are busier than they have been before at certain times, because maybe the staff have been cut down a bit. Maybe there's a reason why, you know, a girl might be working maybe two together, maybe one, you know. But instead of saying, I'm not available, what are you available for? So your phone skills are going to be vitally important here. And I have something to share with you, another fact that just blew my mind. I mean, these are all things I've learned over the years. 63% to 93% of customers, they don't complain. They just leave. You know, another little kind of thought process, again, when you're running your business. I mean, maybe this whole lecture is a bit scary, but sometimes we need to be taken out of our comfort zone to realize that to keep our businesses going. Now, we have a fabulous business. It's a fun industry. We actually work with young people. It's fantastic. And I know there's great crack. The music is playing. The hairdressing is wonderful. But these are things, as the owner, once you put your name over that door, these are your responsibilities to make sure that these things are constantly being monitored. What's measured in a salon is going to be successful. You've got to keep an eye on these things. What's measured and monitored will be successful. Did you know that an unhappy customer will tell 10 people about her bad experience? That's a fact. And now with social media, she can actually tell the world, you know? So take care of those problems promptly, otherwise they will start sharing. This is another part of the workday that we hadn't before, but is very much there now. It costs 6 times more to attract a new client to your salon. So it's so important to look after the good ones and keep them with you. Nobody cares about how much you know until they know how much you care. Remember that, because at the end of the day, again, going back to our soft skills, you have to really, really remember that to look and treat your client like a family member, or maybe not. Maybe it would be better to treat them more like a friend, to welcome your guest, welcome your client, be ready to look after your client the minute that door is unlocked in the morning. And I think it's important also to go back to this, because sometimes what happens is we're all very busy. It's a rushed life. It's a busy life. And particularly for women in business, it's busy. You might have children drop off at school because there is a life outside of your business. But that salon should be ready to work from the time that you say you're opening, not still cleaning the place from the day before, not just doing the till in the morning when the door is open. And your girls should be in that 10 minutes or 15 minutes earlier. Even if you decide, look, we'll leave it closed until 9:30, but we're going to spend the first 15 minutes in the morning being prepared for our client. This is an opportunity. It's a great time in the morning to have morning meetings, and we used to have them in our business. Morning meetings are fantastic because it gives you a great start to the day. It gives you a chance as well to look at your appointment page, your appointment book, your system. Because once you look at that, you can say, right, I've got an appointment there at that time, but I've got more time to talk to that client. And that could be a great time for you to increase your service with the client, work on what you're going to do in your consultation. So instead of just sailing into work, throwing the coat up, drinking a coffee and hopping out onto the floor and hoping that it'll all work out, a little bit of preparation again there is very important. So failing to prepare is preparing to fail. Another little ditty. So just remember that in the morning time, that 15 minutes while you look at your appointment page, it's your time to say, she's coming in there, but I got that space there now. And that time I could actually give her more time in my consultation to upsell and maybe spend more time with my client rather than just getting through quickly and standing around for another half an hour when there's no need for that. There really isn't. This is your time to shine. First thing in the morning is a great time to be there and to give yourself a bit of a chance to get organized for the day. I'd like to talk to you again about communication through body language. And it's actually so true that body language is more powerful than the words that you speak. It's really important to remember that when you're talking to a client or you're with a client, your energy and how you are around them is going to be felt by her. So they've got nothing to do. They just have to sit there and watch you. That's all they do when they come into a salon. They can't even have coffee now and they can't have magazines with COVID. But they've got lots and lots of time just to sit there with a mask and watch everybody around the salon. So your energy around her is going to be really, really important and it will be noticed. And just remember that, you know, soft skills, again, going back to my word, soft skills, it's no shame to be polite. I mean, to say something like, please and thank you, you're welcome to my salon, it's great having you today, thank you for choosing me, I'm delighted to see you. These are things that at the end of the day, the client loves to feel like that. I know that when I've went to a place and people make that much of an effort, it makes me feel good. And it never feels false to me because I just think at least they're trying. They're making an effort with me here today. So this is what we are about. It's the old, it's the old part of our business. It's been there since the beginning of time. Since we first started hairdressing, our relationships and our connection with people is going to be... I've seen girls in a salon with me, right? And I'm being totally honest. I wouldn't have said they were brilliant hairdressers. And that's been truthful. They had massive clienteles. Everybody wanted them. And, you know, I had the salon for so long, but there was about a half dozen of them that stood out in my mind. And a lot of the reason, I mean, I won't say that. I'd say 100% of the reason they had huge clienteles and made a fortune was through communication and really genuinely caring that that client is happy, comfortable, enjoying the experience and wanting to come back again. So I suppose it's what you say, it's how you say it, it's your tone of voice, it's your eye contact, it's that smile, it's your listening skills. These are all things that you can learn. Even if you find, oh, it's a God, it's a lot, isn't it? It becomes so natural. It starts off with a few small changes in the way you approach clients and it grows into your way of being with them. And believe me, it's a joy for you and for her. It becomes a joyful experience and your clientele will build and they will all ask for you. I've seen it. It's proven to me over the years that sometimes I know your hairdressing skills are vital. And I mean, I would consider myself a good stylist and I still consider myself a good hairdresser. But really, it's about the soft skills. It's about the communication and looking after her. And she feels good. I never say he because I was actually always into, you know, ladies hairdressing. So I think that's important to mention. And I keep mentioning it. We'll be doing lots of other lectures. And I'll still keep coming back to this because to me it's hugely important in our business. So we're coming to the end of our lecture. I hope you found it helpful. I've enjoyed giving it very, very much. And I've a lot of experience. I've been at this so long. I mean, I started hairdressing ridiculously young, in fact. I've never done anything else. Well, I did kind of a few things, like around life coaching, and I did psychotherapy and counselling. But really, my main, you know, what I've always done is hairdressing. And if you think about it, the reason I went down for life coaching, and I also did training in counselling and psychotherapy, is because it's around people, and I love being with people so much. So I feel I have a lot to bring, you know, and I'd like to continue doing this and working in this area. I like it. I really enjoyed it so far. So what I would say to you and finished up the lecture today, keep an eye on your competitor. I always kept an eye on my competitor. Not worried, but I like to keep a little eye on what they're doing. Then I always concentrated on my own business. I went back into my salon, I'm back into my business, and every morning and every day I looked after that business. You know, your competitor will do their own thing, and they will do certain things maybe better than you, and you will do certain things better than them. But you specialize in some things and they specialize in some things. But the one thing that you will do is be unique. Don't be afraid to be different. Don't be afraid to change something if it's not working. Don't be afraid to admit that you need to change something that's not working. Don't be afraid to learn more. Don't be afraid to say, do you know what? I did learn something from that. Even if it's only one thing, it's worth listening to. So I'm going to finish up by saying one thing, you know, the little ditty, an attitude of gratitude. Bring it to the table every day. You'll never go wrong.